Hello and welcome to this video about your HbA1c blood test or your diabetes blood test and what it means. This is part of a whole series of videos. If you want to check out other organ systems, just look at the playlist. As always, if your HbA1c blood test you've got back is really, really high, go see your doctor. But if you just want to learn a little bit more about what that blood test means, stay watching. So what is the HbA1c blood test? Well, it's a measure of the sugar in your blood, which is a marker for diabetes. And so it becomes a really important thing that you can track and trend and monitor over time, especially as you start making lifestyle adjustments to help reverse diabetes if that's come along, or to stop you getting it in the first place if you see your levels creeping up. Sugar in the blood can be measured in a lot of ways, and you might see people measuring it with just a finger prick and looking at what those levels are as a snapshot. That's often done by people who are diabetics and on insulin who need to monitor themselves very closely. It's of limited use for the average person that doesn't have that kind of condition. Now, when your blood cells are produced, they start to bond sugar, and they bond it irreversibly for their whole lifespan, which is about 3 or 4 months. So if you have a lot of sugar floating in your blood, the new blood cells bond it for 3 or 4 months, and when we look at your HbA1c, we look at your red blood cells and we can see that they've bonded a lot of sugar, which means that you've got too much sugar in your blood. If you have the normal amount, well, the cells just bond the normal amount and everything looks quite nice. HbA1c is a fantastic marker for diabetes because it's really easy to measure over time and you can track and trend it. Every 3 to 6 months, you can really see the changes of medication or lifestyle interventions which you're making. What's more, we have our values. So I'll give you the English values now, where we can actually start diagnosing and defining diabetes. So if your levels are less than 42, fantastic, you probably don't have diabetes. If your levels are 42 to 47, that's something we call pre-diabetic. That means you are on the path to diabetes and it's time to do something about it. If your levels are over 48, that is in diabetic territory. So if you're not on medication, we look at that kind of thing and think, well, maybe we can reverse that through things like lifestyle. So increasing your exercise levels, so everything from running, cycling, or even just mowing the lawn regularly and going for brisk walks every day, that can help reduce your level. Also changing things like diets, cutting out the simple sugars, cutting out alcohol, cakes, biscuits, crisps, all that kind of crappy junk food. If you can move to a more whole food diet, that will improve your sugar levels as well. Once your levels start going really high, your doctor might start working with you and say that, you know, if lifestyle isn't working, they might start introducing some medication to that as well. The idea being to bring down your sugar levels. So if you're looking at your HbA1c on an annual level and it looks great, fantastic. The moment it starts to start climbing up, that's the time to think to yourself, maybe I need to do more exercise, maybe I need to change my diet a bit, and you can bring those levels down. HbA1c is a fantastic way to track your sugar levels over time. If you have diabetes, it's fantastic for monitoring that condition. If you don't have diabetes, it's a great way to make sure that you're not on a path to getting it. And if you are, you can reverse that through some simple lifestyle modifications. That's HbA1c. I hope that makes sense. And join us next time when we're going to be talking about inflammation in the body with the CRP and the CK. Take care. Thanks. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It really, really helps. If you want to go into a bit more depth, just go to my website here, and you can also follow me on Instagram and ask any questions you like there. Thank you.